Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Friends, welcome back to my channel. I have this HP power adapter. It is 0950-4483. It is 31 volt power adapter. It is not powering on. Let's see what is the problem. If you don't have good practical experience in power electronics, never try to repair because it have live voltage. Set multimeter to DC. I will connect power. It don't have any output. Let's see what is the problem. Let's open it. We need T10 screwdriver. T10. We can see here in this area there is some smoke sign. If we place here, that means in this area there is some smoke reflection. Before touching to this circuit, verify voltage on this DC capacitor. We can see still it have 28 volts. Now I will remove this shield. Circuit is looking clear, clean. If we have voltage on this capacitor, that means its input circuit is clear. Now I will plug in and we will check voltage. DC voltage 164 volts. That means this circuit is clear. Now we need to check the output circuit. Voltage across this capacitor, we don't have any voltage. We have voltage on this main capacitor, bulk capacitor, and we don't have voltage here. That means we have something wrong in this power area, inverter area. Here it is using 200 DT. It is NCP 1200. Here it is using NCP 1200 IC. If we look at its sample circuit, typical circuit, pin number 8 is high voltage pin. It will provide initial charging voltage to VCC capacitor that is connected at pin number 6. Pin number 5, that is drive pin. Pin 4 ground, pin 3 current sense, pin 2 is feedback. Our first concern with pin number 6. We will verify voltage at pin number 8 and 6. It must receive charging voltage at pin number 8, then it will receive VCC voltage at pin number 6. This one is ground, DC voltage, here is pin number 8. It is receiving 14 volt through this combination diode resistor. Here it have 38 volt, then here 14 volt, and it must receive voltage at pin number 6. We need a very special care because 5 and 6 are closer to each other. We can see pin number 6 voltage are not building up. That means there is something wrong. Components connected to pin number 6. Now, if we check transformer configuration, it is using primary winding, spare pin, and it have auxiliary winding. This pin is ground pin. From here, capacitor negative terminal, here, then here, here, here. Then from this jumper to this point, and it is connected to this IC ground pin, pin number 4. That's good. So transformer this end is ground. Auxiliary winding this section from here . Here is capacitor. We need to verify this capacitor. This resistor is burnt out. These resistors have numbers. It don't have marking. It is burned out. Yes, this capacitor is damaged. We can see. This capacitor is damaged. Winding this end jumper, it is reaching here, this resistor overheat, then here is diode. This diode inside, and if we check this diode 0.8, no, it is not a good reading. It must be less than 0.5, it must be around 0.5, 0.6, then it is reaching to this point. It is 33 microfarad, 25 volt. I have 47 microfarad. The original capacitor 33 microfarad, 25 volt. I am using 47 microfarad, 50 volt. 47. Now we need to verify this diode. Yes, this diode is open circuit. It is 1N4148 simple diode. We can see this resistor is damaged. It must be around 30 ohm. It is high value resistor, so it will drop the voltage as well. I will use this resistor. Now let's power it up. Yes, we have 31 volts. Pin number 8. High voltage, then pin number 6, capacitor. This capacitor open. If it is open, it will not store charge. This capacitor is open circuit. When it is open circuit, it will not allow to build the voltage here. So IC cannot take start. The material failure, the capacitor failure, internal failure caused to damage this diode. And there is, normally it must be 30 ohm, 33 ohm, 20 ohm, we can say 10 ohm, up to 30 ohm, 33 ohm, this value must be there. Above than this value, no resistor allowed here, because at that time it will drop the supply current. And here we have bias winding, auxiliary winding. This capacitor damaged, it caused to make short circuit here. This diode 4148 damaged, resistor damaged. Maybe in the last startup it started working, it was working. This capacitor become overheat, short circuit internally. Then this voltage got easiest path, diode short circuit. Resistor damaged. This capacitor become open circuit. So these three components cause to turn off this IC. If you enjoyed this video, hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching.